Have you been looking to up your YouTube game but don't really know how to get started or how to brainstorm your content? I'm going to show you how to get organized today.
Sorry if it's hard to catch my vibe. I need a lover to trust. Tell me you're on my side. Are you down?
What's up, guys? TJ here with another video. If you like these types of videos, please like, share, and subscribe. I really appreciate it. Also, hit that bell icon so you can get notifications whenever I release new videos. So today's video is going to be one that I'm going to be showing you how to organize your YouTube content or any kind of content, really, using a program that I use called Trello. And I'm going to show you exactly my process and my workflow for actually creating content on YouTube and also using Trello to kind of organize my life in a sense. So if you like these types of videos, like, share, subscribe. I really appreciate it. I'm going to put a link in the description section and also in the first comment for Trello. You can sign up for it. It's free. They do have a paid version, but just click on that link and check it out. Let's get into the video. So I'm going to show you how I use Trello to organize my YouTube content and kind of prepare, create, brainstorm, and my general workflow with my YouTube videos. So first of all, if you haven't signed up for Trello, go to the link in the description section or in the first comment of this video. I'll leave a link to Trello for you. But I use the free Trello. I don't pay for it. They do have a paid version, and we'll get into that in a little bit as to what the paid plan looks like. So with the free version, what you can have is you can have unlimited boards, unlimited cards, and you can have one power up, and you won't know what that is until I get into that here in a minute. So let's go home and I'll show you all my boards. So I have a board for my stuff at work, issues with stuff at work, my YouTube channel, my TJ Love Lady brand, financial stuff, and my Instagram. So I have all these different boards that I use for different things. So my Instagram, I just created this one today. I'm going to start curating content for each one of my Instagram pages. These two are, of course, influencer branded pages, and this is my personal page. So I just created that one today. When I go to my YouTube, these are all of my YouTube videos. So what I do is I have three different categories of videos that I normally do, and then I have my ideas. I have my videos that's ready to post, and then I have these are the videos that I've already posted over here. So basically, when I come up with the idea, I come over here to ideas and I'll create an idea. So I'll say idea for video. All right. Now within that, I can go in here and I can type up, I can do my brainstorm and I can say, okay, this is what I want to do. I can go over here, I can attach pictures, I can attach different ideas. If I have to get inspiration from Pinterest or inspiration from different videos, I can put those here. And then as I progress through the brainstorming process, I can put everything inside and I can save it. So as I'm developing this video, I can track that through this card. Now, once I get done with this video, so say for instance, this is a tutorial video. So I've got all my stuff from my tutorial, exactly what I want to talk about, my talking points, and I'll show you what that looks like here in a minute. What I can do with that idea is I can click and drag that onto Tutorial Tuesday or Thursday. I click on that, and now it's in queue for the development of the video. So normally when I have a video like this and I go through and I put all of my details that I want in the video, I go over here to my labels and I've created these labels. So I have editing, I have to film, interview, sponsored, ready, scripted, or to script. So this video I haven't scripted, so I will code it to script, and I would know automatically all the pink ones have to be scripted. So if I want to go in and I want to script this one, I can go through here. I can script. I didn't spell that right. I can script. And once it's scripted, I can go over here. I can take that one off and now I can put it scripted. All right, so now it's just an easy visualization to see exactly where I'm at with the video. So now once this video gets scripted and I've filmed it and everything's ready to go, I can go over here to my label and I can say, okay, this video is ready. All right, so what that means is it's ready for me to put in queue to be uploaded to YouTube. So once it's done, I can click over here and I can say this video is ready to post. All right, so say for instance, I get done with this one and this video is ready to post. I can click over here. So I know what videos are ready to post, what videos still need some sort of editing, or if I need to film it, or if I need to, script it. I have everything here that I can actually do that. So once I get done with that video and it's filmed, it's posted and everything's ready, I can just click it and I can drag it over here to posted videos. Now the reason I keep this posted videos is because I can go back and reference video. So if I want to make a multi-part series, so like my Instacart video, I can go over here and I can say, okay, I'm going to make another Instacart video. So what did I talk about before? Some of these I didn't really script too much. So this one, I just kind of gave some talking points. Normally when I make a video, I don't necessarily script it. I just have, just different talking points and what I'm going to do. So like right here, I put B-roll footage, show how to upload to site, blah, blah, blah. So when I'm going down and looking at what I need to have in the video, I have my specific talking points for that video. One other thing that's really cool that you can do is you can set a due date. So I can say by October 30th, I want to have this video ready to upload. Once I get to the date, I can check it and say, okay, hey, it's done. If it's not checked, it's not done. Once you get closer to that date, this will turn red. So all the ones that need to be workflowed, I automatically can visualize them here. And like this one right here was supposed to be done on September 25th. It's way past September 25th. It's red. I know I need to click on that one. I need to script it and I need to change my due date because now I've passed that date. So that's the general workflow with Trello for my YouTube channel. But like I said, you can use one power up with the free Trello account. So I'm going to show you what that looks like. So when I go over to this board and I go to power ups, they have all these different power ups that you can use. So essentially a power up is just like an extra service for your Trello board. Now, just because you upload a power up to this board, that doesn't mean you have to use that for every board that you make. It's specific to the one board you're on. So this board, I have a calendar. So what I can do with calendar, I can click on calendar up here. And instead of me going in and typing in my due dates, I can just drag these. So I can say that was due on the 24th or it's on the 26th. And it'll automatically change it on here. So this date right here will change based on the calendar view. So that's a really good visualization of your calendar. So I'll show you a different power up that I have. So this is for my job at work. So the power up that I use here is custom fields. So you can add text, numbers, checkbox, dates, and drop down list that you can visualize just straight on the Trello screen. So as you can see here, I have different information that you can see. And if we go in here, you can actually click on these and it will change on the card itself on the outside. So this would be really cool if you want to just have a quick snapshot of what's inside the card on the outside. You may want to use this power up. Like I said, you can only use one power up if you have the free version. If you have the paid version, you can use multiple power ups. So I'm going to eventually transition into the paid version because I use this like every single day, and I just want to make sure that I am progressing along with my workflow. Also, another good thing that I use Trello for is whenever I'm planning my content, say for instance, I go through and I say I want to go ahead and make 6 videos. So I have a shoot day, I'm going to record 6 videos in one day. I have all of my videos ready. So if I have 6 videos here, I can quickly switch between the videos and go from video to video and make sure that I have all of my content right there in one spot. And I have all my talking points. I can have all my videos, and everything's right there for actual shoot day. So that's going to be all today. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section. If you like these types of videos, please like, share, and subscribe. I really appreciate it. Also, hit that bell icon so you can get notifications whenever I release new videos. And I will see you guys on the next one.